So in this lecture, we're going to talk about how chronic inflammation is linked to different disease states. This first slide I popped up on the screen shows you one of my primary areas of interest, certainly before I moved more into cannabis research, which is alcohol. And this basically shows you how ethanol or alcohol impacts the gut, which can basically cause the release of lipopolysaccharide, which is an inflammatory compound that basically interacts with these other messaging systems that causes inflammation in the liver, which then causes the release of cytokines, which impacts the brain. So bottom line is, this is just one example of how inflammation and plays an important role in the context of alcohol use disorder. And also, when you look at the opioid literature, you'll see that inflammation is critical for the opioid literature. Opioid use abuse is known to elevate systemic inflammation, and recent studies suggest that there's also alterations in the gut microbial composition, which induces preferential expansion of pathogenic bacterial species in mice. So these studies in mice suggest that chronic opioid use can change the balance of the bacteria in the gut in a not good way. Now, we need more studies in humans in terms of opioids and inflammation in the gut microbiome, but again, some early suggestions that this is going to be an important area of research. We look at inflammation and tobacco use. We know that tobacco use increases the number of inflammation signals throughout the body, and this is a quick slide to illustrate how that works in terms of smoking and inflammatory signaling. And also, inflammation is super important for obesity, as is the microbiome. So chronic inflammation has been linked to gut microbiota and obesity and insulin resistance, right? So again, these things go together, the gut microbiome and inflammation and these different disease states. And this is a paper you can go and look at if you're interested in looking at some of the details here in terms of how these things are related to each other. And then, you know, you would think, it makes sense, right? Obesity and the gut microbiome and inflammation, how they'd all be related. But even things like mood disorders, we're talking about things like anxiety, depression, these things are also super important. This is a paper from the American Journal of Psychiatry in 2015, just illustrating how basically these things go together in terms of the gut microbiome and exaggerated or chronic inflammatory responses impacting certain pathways that in turn impact your risk for mood disorders. And then I mentioned anxiety already, but yet another paper talking about implications for anxiety and basically how these different sources of inflammation ultimately have an impact on the brain and the risk for anxiety. So what about schizophrenia? This is interesting too, right? So high levels, there's been some work suggesting that high levels of pro-inflammatory cytokines can be found in the blood and cerebral spinal fluid of schizophrenia patients. Also, there are animal models of schizophrenia suggesting immune system disturbances, especially earlier in life, such as infection-triggered immune activation, might also trigger lifelong increased immune system reactivity. Also, severe infections and autoimmune disorders are risk factors for schizophrenia. The vulnerability stress inflammation model, schizophrenia is one that's come out recently that tries to explain these connections across stress, inflammation, and one's risk for schizophrenia. And finally, immune alterations influence dopaminergic, serotonergic, noradrenergic, and glutamatergic neurotransmission. So again, you can read this review in Frontiers in Neuroscience, but basically people are starting to connect the dots, not just for the other disorders we talked about, but also for schizophrenia, in terms of the importance of inflammation, microbiome, et cetera. So in Alzheimer's, you know, we just had the Alzheimer's module not too long ago. This is super important, thinking about the role of inflammation in the context of Alzheimer's. The most recent thinking is that inflammation plays a very important role. And over the long run, inflammatory signaling, chronic inflammation has a looks like it has a very negative impact in terms of risk for Alzheimer's disease. And you see here the linkages that lead to chronic inflammation and neurodegeneration, and how that looks in terms of some of these mechanisms. And if you want to read more about it, I recommend this paper. I'm cited at the bottom of the screen here. And finally, also with Parkinson's disease, this is yet another paper sort of discussing linkages between these different systems and Parkinson's disease. And this illustration here just shows how some of that, you know, basically plays a role in terms of, you know, inflammation, et cetera, and, you know, impact on microglia, et cetera. So again, the point here is not to overwhelm you with lots of slides with ridiculous level of detail and lots of different cell types and signaling pathways, et cetera. But the goal here is to just lay the groundwork so that you know that inflammation and the microbiome are those two mechanisms seem to cut across a lot of different disease states, both medical disease states and psychiatric disease states. And again, to read more about the Parkinson's conceptualization, you can look at this paper here, cited at the bottom of the screen. So again, the point of these last few slides was just to show you the breadth of the literature, not necessarily to get into the details, but to show you that there are a lot of scientists who are very interested in the role of inflammation in the microbiome across these different disease states.